Okay, so I am going to demonstrate how to streak a plate to get isolated colonies of bacteria. So you can see already that I've got all my personal protective equipment on. I've got my lab coat, I've got my gloves, I've got my safety glasses. And I've also got a little workspace set up in front of me. So I've got my Bunsen burner, which I'm going to light. All right, so now I've got the magic Bunsen burner force field over my workspace. And I've also got in front of me, I've got one petri dish, which already has bacterial colonies on it. Okay, so you can see little individual dots of bacteria that are growing on this. This is the plate that I'm going to be inoculating from. And I also have a fresh, uninoculated petri dish with nothing on it. So this one's sterile right now, and I'm going to be basically trying to recreate this plate on this one. So before I do anything, I'm going to go ahead and label my new plate. Okay, and you always want to label it. So you see we've got two parts here. We've got the lid of the petri dish and the bottom that's actually got the agar in it. So you always want to label the bottom with the agar. That way if you drop the plate and the lid rolls off somewhere, the labels stay at the same place that your bacteria are. So I'm going to label this. Test. All right, good. So the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to take this plate and I'm going to draw a big letter K, capital K, on the back of my plate. And I can't do it. All right. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take my plate, I'm going to draw a big capital K on the back of the plate. Right? All right, so you see? K. All right, what this is going to do, this has divided the plate into four sections, okay? And I'm going to do a little something different with each one of these sections, all right? Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do, I have my inoculating loop right here, okay? I'm going to hold this. It's going to be held kind of down at a 45-degree angle like this into the flame, all right? But hopefully you can see that it's glowing red hot, right? Nice and hot. I'm going to count to 10. 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, 4-1000. And that's to let the loop cool off enough that it doesn't kill the bacteria when I touch them. Okay, so now I have my plate here that's got pre-existing bacterial growth. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick one individual colony and just barely touch it with the loop. It doesn't take much. All right. So now I'm going to take our K plate, and I'm going to start in to the left of the letter, okay? I'm going to take the lid off, and I'm going to basically color in this entire segment of the plate, right? So this, again, this is to the left of the letter K. And I'm just going to run the loop back and forth lightly across the surface of the agar, smearing the bacterial growth that I picked up all over that quadrant and nowhere else on the plate. So now the next thing, I'm going to reflame the loop, right? I'm going to heat it up again until it's red hot. That's going to kill off all the bacteria that were already on there. So we'll give it another 10 seconds to cool off, okay? And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to streak from the quadrant that I just streaked across into the top part of the K. Just one streak like that. And now I'm going to, using that one little streak, I'm going to color in that whole quadrant as well. Being careful not to go into any of the other quadrants. So essentially what I've just done is I've diluted that first streak, right? So there's a lot of bacteria in that first quadrant, and I just pulled a very few of them into the next quadrant and colored it in. So I'm going to repeat that, basically moving clockwise around the plate to the other sectors. You see, this whole time I'm basically holding the plate within the force field of protection created by the Bunsen burner. As soon as I'm done with that last quadrant, I'm going to put the lid back on, and I turn it over like this so that the agar is facing up, the lid is facing down. That way when I incubate it, if any condensation forms, it'll form in the lid, and I can just shake it all out. So I'm going to flame this one last time to kill off anything that might be on there, and I'm done. So our plate has been streaked out, and we'll put that in the incubator. And what we can expect is that tomorrow we'll have something that looks more or less like this, right? So you can see that we have growth. It's very thick in the first sector that we streak, and then it's less thick in the next sector, and in the next one after that, we see a few individual colonies, and in the very final one here, you don't see any growth at all. So we have sequentially diluted the culture until we get individual colonies, right? So this is like the routine way. So this is like the routine way that microbiologists isolate clonal populations of organisms, the way that we get colonies to go from. So you'll be doing this once a week with your isolates all semester.